Excuse me? I beat you fair and square in your dreams.
Oh. Emma.
Ash, what are you doing here?
Nice to see you too.
Shouldn't you be off riding a horse or something?
Actually, I'm down here doing business studies. So I guess you'll be seeing a lot more of me around here.
Great. What you meant to say was great.
That's more like it. Anyway, I better be going.
Good idea. How arrogant can you get? I think he's cute.
I'll second that.
You guys have no taste. None. Hey, Amber.
Oh, hey, you just missed Wilfred. He wants you to email him as soon as you get in. He's gone surfing, so he'll get back to you, but it sounds important.
Okay, thanks. I wonder why.
No idea.
Maybe you're getting a promotion.
You think?
How long have you worked here?
A bit over a year.
Well, let's face it, you're an asset to this place. You're a hard worker.
Always early.
And you stay late.
You know, I did suggest to Wilfred last week that he hire a younger supervisor.
Maybe he took my advice.
Maybe.
And I don't want to sound big-headed or anything.
Of course not.
But I'd be perfect for the job.
Well, who knows? Maybe you're about to get the recognition you deserve. Good luck.
See ya.
Ooh, mind if I check my emails?
Go for it.
What's all this?
I was just cleaning out some old stuff.
Cleo.
I had forgotten about this album.
Cleo.
I was just looking through it.
Are you done?
That depends on whether or not you're ready to drop it.
This is me you're talking to, so come on, spill.
Lewis spends all his time with Charlotte. You know, it's like they're hanging out every day. And I don't see him anymore. It's just, I miss him.
Then do something about it.
I can't. He's moved on.
He's got a new girlfriend, Cleo. That doesn't mean that you two can't be friends.
Hey, what's up?
Hey, nothing. Just thought I'd come and say hello. Unless you're busy.
Ah, not at all. Never too busy for you. In fact, I was thinking about you just yesterday.
Really?
Yeah. You know, about all the fun we used to have.
Yeah, we did, didn't we? Hey, I don't suppose you want to go and get a juice or something.
Hello, you two. Can't wait for this. It's going to be totally great. Oh, Lewis is taking me around the point today so I can work on my sketches. Suggested the perfect spot.
That's Lewis. So thoughtful.
Maybe some other time for that juice, huh?
Yeah, sure. Some other time.
Sorry.
It's okay. You've got plans, I understand. See ya.
Bye.
Bye.
So, what do you say?
A lot, and not really that much.
Shove over, let me read.
Emma, you are my most valuable staff member.
He's just being nice.
It's okay, you've been here a lot longer than me. I've been considering your suggestion to appoint a young supervisor. Emma, that's fantastic. Congratulations. You're perfect for the job.
That's the thing. He doesn't actually say here that I got the job.
What do you mean? Who else could he possibly be thinking of?
Hi, girls. Lucky to meet your new supervisor. Me. Okie dokie, these are the new rosters. Now, I've adjusted the shifts to go for 3 hours instead of four.
What? Why?
Well, the theory is it'll maximise staff energy, which will have a positive effect on business.
With the added bonus of shrinking our pay packets.
Well, we all have to make small sacrifices from time to time. Moving on. These are some procedural changes you should be aware of.
Oh, you can't be serious.
It's not as bad as it looks. Now, one more thing, but this you will love. Da 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 da. New uniforms. Hey? What do you think? Uh-huh. Definitely you.
Welcome to the Juice Net Cafe. How can we refresh you? Thanks for your support.
I'm only here to help.
One banana beatbox coming up.
Hey, Em. Cute hat. Why the frown?
It's not a frown.
Cleo, I know your faces, and that is not a happy one.
I'm fine. Lewis has moved on. I just need to accept that.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do. You can't blame him. I mean, look at me. I've got scales and a tail. I'm half fish.
Shall I get the violins out?
Lewis just wants to be with an ordinary girl. Like Charlotte.
Ordinary's boring.
That's not what he thinks.
Trust me, Lewis likes different. And all you need to do is embrace your differences.
Embrace the fact I'm a fish?
You're not a fish. You're a mermaid.
I don't get it.
Charlotte doesn't have anything you don't have, right?
I guess.
But you have something she doesn't.
Yourself.
Any bites?
No, not even a nibble. I think it must be the bait.
The bait, huh?
I got it from the boat shed. I think it might be a little on the nose.
Well, if you wanted, I could take you somewhere where the bait's really fresh. It's not far, just past the point.
How'd you find it?
There are some perks to being a mermaid, you know. Come on, it'll be fun.
Think of all the changes. You know, the short shifts, the uniforms, the procedures.
Oh, yeah, that. With Ashran, I've been so busy I didn't even notice.
So, what do you think about...
Ash says I should take on more responsibility. He's a great leader.
Yeah, about the...
He's got great business skills. He says that we...
Emma! I want to know what you think of the changes. Ash, hi. Just about to wipe down some tables.
Actually, Emma, if you've got a second, I wanted to call a staff meeting.
Now?
Is that a problem?
No. It's just that we've got customers to serve.
It won't take long. Okay, menu. A few changes, like banana beatbox. That's out.
What? That was my favourite smoothie.
It wasn't selling.
I put a lot of research into that.
And it wasn't selling.
Ash, it took me 2 months to get that recipe right. It tastes great. Doesn't it taste great?
It's okay, I guess.
You feel really strongly about this, don't you?
Yeah, actually, I do.
Well, too bad. It wasn't selling. Does anybody else have any problems? No? Good. Let's sell some juice.
That was a great idea. Thanks.
Pleasure. It was fun.
Yeah, it was.
Hey, I haven't seen you around much lately.
Yeah, well, we've both been pretty busy.
Yeah, but we should try and keep in touch. You know, maybe hang out sometime.
I'd like that.
Thanks again.
Lewis. Where have you been?
Not that far.
Really?
Came down about half an hour ago. There's no sign of you.
I went to get some more bait.
Without your phone?
Yeah, must have.
You never go anywhere without your phone.
Charlotte, it's fine.
No. Derek gets stored next to the fruit, so it's easy to access. Here, let me help.
Oh, hold your horses. There's a new cool room procedure.
Of course there is.
I've changed the temperature controls so we can keep the fruit and dairy separate.
Just for fun, or...?
Well, if the fruit gets too cold, it loses flavour. So, from now on, it's fruit on the left, dairy on the right.
Right then.
Is something wrong?
Oh, no, you've only turned the whole Juice Net Cafe upside down in less than 3 hours. Why would something be wrong?
You're mad at me.
Wow, you're really observant.
You know, Em...
You can call me Emma.
Right, Emma. I know that you have issues with the way things are changing around here. And I know it's probably because you wanted my job.
So you're psychic too.
All I'm saying is that I just think you should give me more than one day before you judge me.
There was nothing wrong with the old cool room procedure.
Trust me, Em. Sorry. Emma. Things will just go more smoothly if you work with me and not against me. Just try it. You'll see. It's a win-win situation.
I still don't get where you went.
I told you, fresh bait.
Lewis, most people just buy bait from the shop. They don't swim after it and catch it by hand.
I am very dedicated.
There's something you're not telling me.
Charlotte, there are some things in life that are best left a mystery. Okay?
Is that your way of telling me to mind my own business?
Why, yes. As a matter of fact, it is.
Hey. I think I've got one.
I do.
Okay, guys. Well, I'm sure we can all agree that the 60s surf theme is a little old. That's why we're switching to basketball. Now, as you can see, I've put up a few hoops around the place. And starting tomorrow, every hour, I want you guys to put on a show. You know, take a few shots, really play it up for the crowd.
What's all this got to do with selling juice?
Simple. Customers run around, get all hot and bothered. They buy more juice. It's not rocket science. All right, leave it up to you guys. Hey, oh! Oh!
Okay, I'm sure I'm not alone with my concerns about these changes. I mean, for this guy to come in and turn the place upside down in the space of a day, it's a joke, right?
Actually, I think Ash's idea is really great. It sounds like a lot of fun.
Come on, we've got to take a stand. You might think Ash is a great guy, but he really doesn't know a lot about the Juice Net Cafe. And it's not his fault, but he's clearly out of his depth. And he's standing right behind me, isn't he?
You don't like the new theme? Come on. Remember what we talked about, working with me, not against me? Just relax and embrace the changes. Chances are they won't be as bad as you think.
Relax.
and embrace the changes. How can I be expected to work with that jerk? All he's done is read a few books and now he thinks he knows everything.
Wow.
Wow what? You'd lose it too if you had to work with him.
He's definitely pushing your buttons.
I deserve that position, not him.
You want to know what I think?
Not particularly.
I think there's chemistry.
Excuse me? You think wrong. I'm definitely not attracted to him.
I didn't say there was attraction. I said there was chemistry. Hey, how's it going?
Good.
I had a really good time yesterday.
Yeah, me too.
Well, see you around.
See ya.
You didn't tell me Cleo was with you yesterday.
Didn't I?
No. You conveniently left that point out.
Cleo's a good friend, Charlotte, and I don't think I need to tell you every time I hang out with her.
Yeah. You're right. And besides, with me now.
Yeah. All set to butt heads with Ash again?
Nope. I'm not worried about him at all. I thought about it, and I realised something.
What's that?
I know the Gooseneck Cafe better than he does. All the changes he's made will be bad for business. And as soon as Wilfred realises that, he'll fire Ash so quickly his head will spin. Who's gonna fall for that tired basketball stuff anyway? Besides, there's no one here.
Fresh watermelon on the house. It's frozen. Gotta check those cool room settings. Frozen watermelon, anybody?
Yes, please. Watermelon.
So much. Yum. Yum. Everybody loves him.
Except you.
Maybe I judged him too quickly.
You think?
I mean, the cafe's thriving and all the other staff seem happy. Maybe I was wrong. I better be getting back.
Emma, can I have a word, please?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, thanks.
Okay. First, you complain about changes to the menu, then the uniform, then you try to turn the staff against me. Emma, I've tried to keep my cool, but this time you've gone too far.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I asked you to store the dairy on the right-hand shelves.
That's what I've been doing.
Really? See, this is exactly the kind of wastage that we're trying to avoid.
Why are you assuming that it was me?
Because you're the only one who seems to have an attitude problem.
Well, maybe you shouldn't have made so many changes at the same time. Did you think of that?
I'm disappointed, Emma. I know you have problems with the new procedures, but I need people I can rely on.
That's not fair.
I'm sorry, Emma. You leave me with no choice.
better let you go.
I'm fired. Fine.
Oh, Amber, what are you doing?
Just unpacking the dairy.
I don't suppose you unpacked it last night.
Oh, yeah, filled those shelves, same as always. Whatever you've got to say, I'm not interested.
Just please, just give me a chance.
Why should I? You didn't give me one.
I'm here to apologize. I was wrong.
No kidding.
Just let me finish. I know I misjudged you.
Yep, you sure did.
And I want you to come back to the cafe. We can start again.
Maybe I don't want to come back.
Oh, come on, Emma. I said I was sorry. And I shouldn't have even blamed you. It was Amber anyway.
So are you going to fire her as well?
No, I realised that was a bit harsh. Come on. You're the best worker we've got. We'll be lost without you. I'll put banana beatbox back on the menu. And I'll scrap the ugly hats.
And what about the basketball theme?
I've been rethinking that anyway. Come on, what do you say? Yes, thank you. I really am sorry. I should have listened to your advice.
Thanks.
I'm man enough to admit when I'm wrong.
I might have been wrong as well.
You wrong? Never.
See, that is the kind of attitude that really gets under my skin.
Well, that's something we have in common.
I doubt it.
What? Just... Do I go to the movies tonight?
What?
Pick you up around 6.
Fine. Don't be late.